For the past several years, SpaceX has been developing Starship, a giant new deep space rocket at the company's test facility in South Texas.
Starship heading back to the lander zone.
Testing of Starship prototypes has resulted in fiery failures. But last year, Starship completed its first successful suborbital flight and landing. Now, SpaceX CEO Elon Musk says 2022 is the year Starship will face its biggest test yet, orbital flight.
I feel, at this point, highly confident that it will get to orbit this year.
However, it's possible that Starship's historic first orbital flight test might take place at the Kennedy Space Center in Florida, rather than at Starbase in Boca Chica, Texas. That's because flight safety regulators could end up determining more environmental reviews are needed for the Texas site.
An orbital test flight is a really big milestone, you know, for Starship or really for any, you know, rocket that's going to space.
So, why, after years of development in Texas, could SpaceX's Starship make its most important flight to date in Florida? And what could that switch mean for SpaceX's operations going forward? On Thursday, February 10th, SpaceX CEO Elon Musk gave his first update on the company's Starship program in about 2 years. Towering behind him at the company's South Texas Starbase was Starship.
The essential technology, the holy grail breakthrough that's needed, is a rapid and completely reusable rocket system.
When stacked on top of its massive booster, called Super Heavy, Starship stands at 120 meters, or 400 feet, making it the tallest rocket ever constructed.
Starship, according to Elon Musk, is meant to go to Mars. The Starship rocket system is meant to be a fully reusable, multi-planetary rocket system.
NASA selected Starship as the vehicle to get astronauts to land on the surface of the moon by 2025. And the Pentagon said it wants to use Starship to transport military cargo. But before all that can happen, Starship needs to be tested in orbit.
SpaceX has been able to conduct these shorter flights, no more than 18 miles up. But this year, you know, Elon Musk says he's pretty sure that Starship is going to go to orbit.
The orbital test mission still needs sign-off from the FAA, which has been conducting an environmental assessment of the company's proposal to operate Starship in Texas.
The FAA, of course, is even looking at this in the first place because the agency monitors and regulates space launch facilities, launches themselves, and then re-entries.
Last year, the FAA held hearings about the Starship proposal for the Texas location and received around 19,000 comments on the initiative.
One of the questions with the FAA's current review for the proposal for Starship in Texas is, are they going to have to do additional review on environmental grounds, you know, beyond that?
In 2021, the Journal reported that Boca Chica residents said the Starship project is damaging to the local wetlands and wildlife.
They move in and change the whole tone and tenor of the place, but they began to do 24/7 construction, which meant, you know, wall-to-wall people, cars, traffic, noise, lighting, you name it.
The agency is considering, you know, the potential impact of using the vehicles at the site, everything from noise to what it would mean for surrounding wildlife and wetlands.
Musk said that if, in addition to its current environmental assessment, or EA, the FAA requires SpaceX to conduct a more in-depth EIS, or environmental impact statement, of the Starbase site, SpaceX would consider moving its orbital test to the Kennedy Space Center. In a statement, the FAA wrote, "Completing the environmental review does not guarantee that a vehicle operator license will be issued to SpaceX. The environmental review is just one part of the FAA commercial space licensing process. SpaceX must also meet FAA safety, risk, and financial responsibility requirements."
It would obviously set us back for quite some time because an EIS takes a lot longer than an EA. So we would have to shift our priorities to Cape Kennedy.
SpaceX already has permission to use a launch site at the Kennedy Space Center for Starship. In December, Musk said in a tweet that SpaceX had started building an orbital launch pad for Starship at the Florida location.
The short answer to if, you know, is SpaceX abandoning Texas, you know, to shift this program to Florida is no. It's possible that the Starbase site could end up as SpaceX's kind of long-term sort of research site, R&D, whereas the operational sort of launch pad would be in Florida. They know that they're good to go there, you know, in terms of like all environmental reviews and analysis. It's sort of more plug and play. Whereas Texas, you still have this question of what the result of the current review is going to be, and at least the possibility that there's going to be another environmental review, you know, beyond that.
The FAA said it planned to release its environmental review on March 28th.
We don't have a ton of insight into where things stand with the FAA. We have gotten sort of a rough indication that there may be an approval in March, but that's all we know.
We'll culminate with landing on the landing pad in Boca Chica.